So as we all know, slugs are quite a problem. And in Western Victoria, we're also seeing them do quite a lot of damage in wheat last season. So timing of baiting is absolutely critical. It doesn't matter what product you use, you need to get the timing right. So this site here in South Australia is a different set of environmental conditions to what we've got in Western Victoria, all that aimed at trying to give growers recommendations of when is the best time to put bait on. So for Western Victoria, we know putting bait on at sowing is critical to protect the emerging seedlings. There seems to be a little bit more confusion here in South Australia because the slugs don't always turn up at sowing time. So quite often baits are going on too late, in my opinion. So we're doing some research today to do that. And so we'll go and have a look at one of those plots now. There it is. So we're using the traditional surface refuges, which is what I've commonly been recommending growers do to monitor for slugs. I'm using two per plot. Yep, we've got five slugs under that refuge there. So this is an untreated control. We were going to apply some treatments on as a late treatment to see if we can control the population for next season, for the crop going in next year. So if this was canola next year, knowing the likely risk and trying to reduce those numbers. That's the traditional way of monitoring using a couple of tiles, and I'm still using that in my experiments. So the slugs under this tile here actually look quite sick. And there's been a big question this year is, where have the slugs gone? What's going on? There aren't the slug pressures this year. And so we're actually needing new monitoring techniques to try and understand the population changes over time and actually what's going on. So we've been using some new technology that we'll go over here and have a look at. So after checking the tiles over in my timing experiment and using an old method for monitoring slug populations, we're moving to the more modern technology, trying to improve monitoring, because monitoring is key for integrated pest management programs. And so we've got to give tools to growers that actually shows them when the slugs are active and actively feeding. So we're using these little Brinno cameras here. They're set up to take a time-lapse photo every minute, and we've got a light so we can see the things running around at night. I've had this out for about a month, come along. So we put the stick out of the camera in the laptop, and so then we've got a record of when the slugs are active. Now what we're trying to do with that information is actually tie it to the environment. Slugs like moisture with a no-till system and lots of cover and everything like that. Perfect conditions for them. So we're trying to actually measure the conditions down there with these little sensors. We've got a leaf wetness sensor. We're doing relative humidity at the ground. So we've got a little sensor in there that's also doing ground temperature. We're looking at soil moisture as well. And we're recording all that information. So hopefully we can come up with tools of knowing when these things are active so farmers can get their bait timing right so they can implement integrated pest management programs and get better control of slugs.